The Melbourne and Hobsons Bay Railway Company of Victoria operated Australia's first steam rail service in 1854. With this modest beginning enthused a spirit of progress that subsequently saw the Victorian Government Railways extend its main line to its northeastern limit, the banks of the Murray River at Wodonga in 1873. Across the border, the Great Southern Railway was unfolding from Sydney and would be completed to Albury by February 1881. 2 years later, in 1883, a temporary trestle bridge was constructed across the Murray, and Australia's first intercapital rail connection was celebrated with a lavish banquet in the Albury engine shed. The celebrations ignored a most contentious point, for both lines were destined never to meet, as Victoria had adopted the broad gauge of 5'3", whilst New South Wales the standard gauge of 4'8.5". For the next 79 years, the 960-kilometre Sydney-Melbourne line would be broken by Albury's number one platform, where passengers and their luggage would be required to change trains, please, in order to complete their through journey. On the 3rd of January 1962, a freight train leaving Sydney signalled the opening of the new inter-capital standard gauge line. Not long after, on April the 16th, the new passenger express Southern Aurora pulled out of Sydney to pioneer the new standard gauge public service to Melbourne. In April 1992, to celebrate 30 years of standard gauge passenger service, we joined steam enthusiast at Albury's number one platform. Handsomely preserved, J515 is one of 60 J-class locos originally constructed in England by the Vulcan foundry and shipped to Melbourne ready for active service in March 1954. The first 30 were built as coal burners, the second 30 equipped as oil burners, and all were constructed in such a way as to be easily converted to standard gauge running if necessary. By By December 1954, just 9 months after their delivery, the last of the class, number 559, was also the last steam locomotive to enter service on Victoria Railways. Just 13 years later, in November 1967, scrapping started and many were relegated to shunting duties or working the light branch lines. Some were put into store at country depots and saw seasonal work hauling bountiful wheat harvest during the good years. .507 and .515 were the last two in regular service. Acting as yard pilots, they worked Melbourne's Newport yards as late as mid-1972. J515, seen here, has been preserved by the Seymour Loco Steam Preservation Group and returned to traffic on the 4th of June 1988. It's now 20 years since 5910 was withdrawn from service. Originally, 20 D59 class locomotives were built in America by the Baldwin Locomotive Works for the New South Wales Government Railways. The 59s entered traffic in August 1952 as oil burners of the light Mikado class and weighing in at 150 tonnes. Just 10 years later in 1962, all except three of the class were converted to coal. 59 class locos did not work the southern line to Goulburn until mid-1966, by which time Australia's rail passengers were buying tickets with decimal currency and the railways were sold on diesel power. Steam was destined for the museums. After an extended excursion through to Melbourne, we catch 3642 returning to Albury. With about 50 kilometres to go, the flat terrain makes for easy running. 3642 was built by the Clyde Engineering Works at Granville, New South Wales, between October 1926 and June 1928, at a cost of £11,338. That's about $22,700. The first C36 class steam locomotive was built in 1925 by the New South Wales Government Railways at Everley Locomotive Workshops. In total, 75 locomotives were built and 29 were given the green colour scheme. 3642 was withdrawn from regular service in 1967 and placed into storage at Enfield. In 1969, the remainder of the C36 class locos were taken out of service. Now, only three remain. The 3642 was located to Thilmere Rail Transport Museum in 1975, then rebuilt at Goulburn Loco Works between January 1979 and November 1981. This steel lattice girder bridge was prefabricated in England by the Stockton Forge Company, shipped to Sydney and then railed to Albury. Replacing a temporary trestle bridge, it was used for the first time in October 1884 and is still fully serviceable today. Prior to the bridge arriving, however, river gravel was removed from the Victorian side for levee works, making the river wider, so a timber extension add-on was required to span the extra distance. We board 3642 as she slips out tender first from Albury Loco for recoaling at the southern end of Albury Yards. Coaling facilities at Albury Yards have been dismantled for some time now, so an improvised operation utilises one of the sidings and a contract front-end loader to unceremoniously dump the coal into the tender.
Thank you. red man, what about it? Up here. Where's he going?